Good morning, and welcome to Old St. Mary's Church. My name is Leah McCroskey, and I'm in Mr. Carpenter's fifth grade at Old St. Mary's School. Today is October 11, 2022. It is the 28th week of Ordinary Time. Today we will be celebrating the Mass at the memorial of Pope St. John the 22nd. Please stand and join us in our opening song as we gather at our table on page 924.
That's number 924, 924.
As we gather at your table, as we listen to your word, help us know, God, your presence. Let our hearts and minds be stirred. Nourish us with sacred story till we claim it as our own. Teach us through this holy banquet how to make love's victory known. Turn our worship into witness in the sacrament of life. Send us forth to love and serve you, bringing peace where there is strife. Give us, Christ, your great compassion to forgive as you forgave. May we still behold your image in the world you died to save. Gracious Spirit, help us summon other guests to share that feast, where triumphant love will welcome those who had been less than least. There no more will envy blind us, nor will pride our peace destroy, as we join with saints and angels to repeat the sounding joy.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. How you doing this morning? You have a good weekend?
Yes.
Like the extra day off?
Yes.
I heard a yes and no on that? Okay. Well, we'll keep working on all that. This morning as we gather, we have a special feast day. It's a newer feast on the calendar. It's the memorial of Saint Pope John the 23rd. And that he dates back to the 1960s. I'll get into that a little bit in the homily. But if you ever saw John the 23rd, you would think he's kind of a jovial, bouncy guy. He could easily play Santa Claus. He was built that way. But he also had great humor, great fun, and great faith. And so we celebrate that as we come together today. And we ask for God's help as we ask for his mercy. Lord Jesus, you sent your Son in, you came into our world to teach us the ways of love of God. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, at the conclusion of your ministry, you sent your disciples to share your good news with all the world. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you sent the Spirit to be with us that we may share your mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who in Pope St. John the 23rd has given a living example of Christ the Good Shepherd to shine throughout the whole world, grant us that through his prayers we may joyfully pour out an abundance of charity. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Let's be seated to hear God's word.
A reading from the book of Ezekiel. For thus say the Lord God, look, I myself will search for my sheep and examine them, as a shepherd examines his flock while he himself is among his scattered sheep. So I will examine my sheep and deliver them from every place they were scattered on the day of the dark clouds. I will lead them out from among the peoples and gather them from the lands. I will bring them back to their own country and pasture them upon the mountains of Israel, in the ravines in every inhabited place in the land. In good pastures I will pasture them. On the mountain heights of Israel will be the grazing land. There they will lie down on good grazing land, rich pastures that will be pastured on the mountains of Israel. I myself will pasture the sheep. I myself will give them rest. Oracle of the Lord God. The lost I will search out. The strays I will bring back. The injured I will bind up, and the sick I will heal. But the sleek and the strong I will destroy. I will shepherd them in judgment.
El Señor es mi pastor, nada me falta. My shepherd is the Lord, nothing more shall I need. El Señor es mi pastor, nada me falta. My shepherd is the Lord, nothing more shall I need. My shepherd is the Lord, I have all I need. Green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Calm and soothing are the waters where he leads me to revive my spirit. El Señor es mi pastor, nada me falta. My shepherd is the Lord, nothing more shall I need. He guides me in paths of righteousness, true to his name. Though I walk in death's dark valley, no evil will I fear. You are with me by my side, your rod and your staff give me comfort. El Señor es mi pastor, nada me falta. My shepherd is the Lord, nothing more shall I need. prepare a lavish feast, spreading it before me, while my enemies are there looking on. You anoint my head with oil, you fill my cup so full it runs over. El Señor es mi pastor, nada me falta. My shepherd is the Lord, nothing more shall I need.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Now, just to give you a context for this gospel reading, this reading takes place after Jesus' resurrection from the dead, and he's gathered with his disciples, and so he says this. After Jesus had revealed himself to his disciples and eaten breakfast with them, he said to Simon Peter, "Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these?" Simon Peter answered him, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you." And Jesus said to him, "Feed my lambs." Then he said to Simon Peter a second time, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" Simon Peter answered him, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you." He said to him, "Tend my sheep." He said to him the third time, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" Peter was distressed that he had said to him a third time, "Do you love me?" And he said to him, "Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you." And Jesus said to him, "Feed my sheep." The Gospel of the Lord. First, I wanted to ask how many runners competed this past weekend, if you just raise your hand. Okay, I want to congratulate you on your victories and on your movement to state for this week. Why don't we all congratulate them? Now, if you're a runner, or if you're a swimmer, or you compete in any kind of a race, who is the most important person at the race? I'll go off mic a moment.
The person who wins it because they're the one that can make it all out. Okay? It needs something. starter.
That's right, the starter, the one who fires the gun or pushes the button and gets everyone. Everyone else just waits for that person. I suppose they could be the starter, the judge, or, but they're the one that control the race. No one goes until they say you can go. And if you go early, they shoot it twice and you all come back. That's true in swimming. It's true in lots of athletic feats. And I say that because every race, everything that's special that ever occurs in our world has to have someone to start it. And until they start it, you can't see what all the consequences are. And the reason I say this today is because without Pope John the 23rd, without Pope John the 23rd, what we do in the church today would not be happening. Now, why do I say that? Well, Pope John the 23rd was never expected to be a pope. He was elected by other cardinals because he was old. They knew he wouldn't last long. They knew he wouldn't do much. They were wrong. Now, it is true, he didn't last long. He was only pope 5 years, but every other pope since him has depended on him. Now, I told you that he was kind of rotund, read that as heavy set. That never stopped him from being jolly. But he was not only round and jolly, he was smart as a whip. And he lets you know that he loved you and cared about you and was interested in what you were doing. And in his mind, he was also knowing God made you something special. And the way he has made you something special, I'm going to try to figure out what that was. So that's the heart. I think that's why Pope John the 23rd became a saint, because he loved greatly. Now, for those of you who are studying church history, you can't get around John the 23rd. John the 23rd, does his name sound like another pope's name?
Yes.
Such as? Such as John Paul I, John Paul II. And when you hear the names John Paul I, John Paul II, can you guess who the pope was after John the 23rd? No, you got to look to John Paul I and John Paul II. Who followed John the 23rd? No, you're not listening. John Paul I and John Paul II followed Pope John and Pope Paul. That's why Pope John Paul chose John Paul, was he wanted to honor the two popes who were ahead of him. And he only lasted 30 days. And so when John Paul II gets elected pope, and he reigned a lot of years, he affirmed what was already being done by John the 23rd and Paul the 6th, and then John Paul I. What John the 23rd also did was he started something called the Second Vatican Council. He called together all the bishops in the entire world and said, "We got to talk about what's going on in the world." Some people would say, maybe we're ready for another council because there's an awful lot going on in our world. But they came together, the bishops came together, they were given an agenda that they were supposed to accomplish, and it all got changed. So what we celebrate in Mass today is because of St. John the 23rd. He got us to look at things differently. He started asking the questions that people were afraid to ask because he knew that with God's help, there was no fear. With God's help, we were going to be guided forward. He was known for saying little quips to people. Like he was once asked by a reporter who was visiting the Vatican. He said, "How many people in the Vatican work?" And you know what his answer was? About half. Okay, if you don't get it, you don't get it. How many kids do work in the school? There we go. So about half. He was also, he would change things. So before him, Pius XII was a pope who used to eat alone. Now, if you ever looked at Pius XII and John the 23rd, you'll see one's very skinny and one's bigger. And but they also, Pius XII dined alone, but John the 23rd didn't want to do that. So someone ventured to remind John that Pius XII usually ate alone. And Pope John said, "Well and good. I value tradition, and I grant that my predecessors did too. I must confess, however, that I have never found any place in the Bible which suggests that a pope should eat alone." And in fact, you could probably say, if John the 23rd was sitting here with us and he was reminding us we're in this year of Eucharistic renewal, that our celebration of Mass tells us that we are not meant to eat alone. We are meant to know the people we are with. We are meant to understand the prayers we say. We are meant to participate with our voices, with our actions, with our coming forward to receive the Eucharist. I invite you to look up John the 23rd online, to look at him and his legacy. He did many other things. He worked very hard to help peace to be part of our world. He worked very hard to make sure that the Cuban Missile Crisis would end quietly. He worked very hard to help people know that we must share love, even in places that people said, "Oh, you can't do that because they're different from us." But he always said, "No, it's about love." And so he's the starter pistol that gets us going into our faith today. May we be open to what he shared then that became part of Paul VI, John Paul I, and John Paul II, and especially Pope Francis, who tries to take all the lessons of our popes and lead us forward to establish Christ's presence with love. Let us stand. So this gathering in love reminds us there are people we need to pray for, and so we now offer our prayers.
For the Old St. Mary's community, all the priests, deacons, and members of the church, that they follow God's love and example, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our world's leaders, may they lead with wisdom and compassion, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those affected by natural disasters, especially those affected by the floods in Pakistan, that they may experience support from our global community, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
For those who are suffering in mind or body, that they find healing and consolation through care and support, we pray to the Lord.
For those who have passed away, and for Fanny Sue Greer, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the internet that we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in our world, especially in the nations of Ukraine and Afghanistan, we pray to the Lord.
We pause also a moment to consider the prayers of those who join us either online or those who join us with their hearts. for their prayers, we pray to the Lord. Gracious God, you hear these prayers that we have voiced. You know the prayers in our hearts. You know those that we do not even know yet. Grant all that we need through the great mystery of your love, through Christ our Lord.
Let's sing number 827, My Shepherd, You Supply My Need. That's number 827.
My Shepherd, You supply my need, O soul, is your name. In pastures green, you make me free beside the living stream. You bring my spirit back when I forsake your ways, and lead me for your mercy's sake in paths of truth and the shades of death, your presence is my stay. One word of your supporting breath drives all my fears away. Your hand inside of all my foes does till my table spread. My cup with blessings overflows, your oil anoints my head. The sure provisions of my God attend me all my days. Oh, may your house be my abode, and all my work be praised. There would I find a settled rest, while others go and come, no more a stranger or a guest, but like a child at home.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who made blessed John the vicar of Peter and committed to him the care of the church, by his intercession, keep your beloved flock ever safe, so that with integrity of faith and perfect charity, your church may journey to her heavenly homeland. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. God, our loving Father, we are glad to give you thanks and praise because you love us. Because you love us, you gave us this great and beautiful world. Because you love us, you sent Jesus, your Son, to bring us to you and to gather us around him as children of one family. For such great love, we thank you with the angels and saints as they praise you and they sing.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
Loving Father, blessed be Jesus, whom you sent to be the friend of children and of the poor. He came to show us how we can love you, Father, by loving one another. He came to take away sin, which keeps us from being friends, and hate, which makes us all unhappy. He promised to send the Holy Spirit to be with us always, so that we can live as your children. God, our Father, we now ask you to send your Holy Spirit to change these gifts of bread and wine into the body and blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord. The night before he died, Jesus, your Son, showed us how much you loved us. When he was at supper with his disciples, he took bread, gave you thanks and praise, then broke the bread and gave it to his friends as he said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, Jesus took the cup that was filled with wine. He thanked you, gave it to his friends, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
And so, loving Father, we remember that Jesus died and rose again to save the world. He put himself into our hands to be the sacrifice we offer you. Listen to our prayer. Send the Holy Spirit to all of us who share in this meal. May the Spirit bring us closer together in the family of the Church, with Francis, our Pope, and Blaise, our Bishop, all other bishops, and all who serve your people. Remember, Father, our families and friends, and all those we do not love as we should. Remember those who have died. Bring them home to you to be with you forever. Gather us all together in your kingdom. There we shall be happy forever with the Virgin Mary, Mother of God and our mother and patron, with Joseph, her spouse, and there all the friends of the Lord Jesus Christ, especially Pope John the 23rd and all the saints will sing a song of joy. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
The words Jesus himself gave us, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may all be free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer each other some sign of Christ's peace. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall.
Let's sing number 1028, You Satisfy the Hungry Heart, number 1028.
Satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest sweet. Come give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to eat. As when the shepherd calls his sheep, they know and heed his voice. So when you call your family, Lord, we follow and rejoice. You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest sweet. Come give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to eat. With joyful lips we sing to you our praise and gratitude, that you should count us worthy, Lord, to share this heavenly food. You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest sweet. Come give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to eat. Is not the cup we bless and share the blood of Christ outpoured? Do not one cup, one loaf declare our oneness in the Lord? You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest sweet. Come give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to eat. The mystery of your presence, Lord, no mortal tongue can tell, whom all the world cannot contain, comes in our hearts to dwell. You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest sweet. Come give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to eat. You give yourself to us, O Lord, then selfless let us be, to serve each other in your name, in truth and charity. You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest sweet. Come give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to eat. As when the shepherd calls his sheep, they know and heed his voice. So when you call your family, Lord, we follow and rejoice. You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest sweet. Come give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to eat. With joyful lips we sing to you our praise and gratitude, that you should count us worthy, Lord, to share this heavenly food. You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest sweet. Come give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to eat. Is not the cup we bless and share The blood of Christ outpoured. Do not one cup, one loaf declare our oneness in the Lord. You satisfy the hungry heart with gift of finest sweet. Come give to us, O saving Lord, the bread of life to
Let us pray. O Lord our God, may the sacraments we have received stir up in us that fire of charity which Blessed John burned ardently as he gave himself unceasingly for your church, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Mass is ended. You are sent to live the faith we teach.
Let's sing number 820, The King of Love, My Shepherd Is, number 820.
King of love, my shepherd is, whose goodness fails me never. I nothing lack if I am his, and he is mine forever. Where streams of living water flow, my ransomed soul he's leading, and where the verdant pastures grow, with food celestial feeding. Confused and foolish oft I strayed, but yet in love he sought me, and on his shoulder gently laid, and home rejoicing brought me. In death's dark veil, I fear no ill. with you, dear Lord, beside me. Your rod and staff, my comfort still. Your cross before to guide.